great chefs have in common, I suppose, generosity. You want to sort of give off that aura of like generosity and friendship and warmth inside your restaurant. We're all a little bit crazy, but the amount of hours we work and the effort what goes into our work, and also it's our desire to create beautiful food on a plate. That's what we all have in common. What made me want to become a chef? It was purely because I've just had this love affair with food. Even when I was a small child, my parents had a seaside resort guest house. My parents would cook, clean. Look, the hospitality is sort of in my blood. And it was just one of those things what I grew up with. And I just one day wanted to become a chef, and here I am. What defines a really great dinner party? For me, it's got to be simplicity. So many people put so much effort into dinner parties that they spend all the time in the kitchen and no time in the dining room hosting their friends and family or whatever it's supposed to be. So for me, it's keep the food simple and make sure you spend as much time in the dining room as possible entertaining your guests. A party to make it memorable for me would have to be great drinks, great company, great food, and most importantly, if it's going to be a party, great music. The perfect drink to get a party started. Oof. See, there's so many great drinks to start a party. If I was in the East, I would probably serve something with whiskey. Everyone loves whiskey over there, and I'd probably have a lot of fun with a nice whiskey cocktail with some sort of tropical fruit in it, something like that. My preferred after dinner drink would have to be Louis XIII. Amazing cognac, purely because it's just got such depth of flavour. Yes, it's a real treat. Yes, it's expensive, but it's the king of cognac.